The president reportedly has already been treated with an experimental drug cocktail that's meant to reduce the viral load.
Dana Rebick joining us with that part of our coverage this evening. Dana?
That's right. Well, we do know from the president's doctor that he is feeling fatigued, but in good spirits. The first lady showing signs, we're told, of a mild cough and headache as the nation and medical experts weigh in and watch closely for updates on the president's condition.
Just like we're concerned for everybody that has COVID disease, you know, the same concerns apply in terms of, you know, how's he doing? How is he progressing?
The country's focus on the nation's capital as doctors here in Chicago watch closely the medical response to President Trump's COVID-19 diagnosis. In a White House memo tonight, President Trump's doctor says he received an 8-gram dose of a polyclonal antibody cocktail from the company Regeneron.
It contains two antibodies. They're called neutralizing antibodies. And basically, they attach to a certain protein in the virus that renders the virus less active, less capable of avoiding treatment.
Mimicking a powerful immune response, Regeneron's investigational therapy is currently being tested for in and outpatient use that could be given to people recently diagnosed or those who have been exposed to someone who has tested positive. The president got access through what's called a compassionate use request. As far as what could be next if the president's symptoms worsen,
if somebody has problems with their oxygen and has pneumonia, we'll start them on therapy such as remdesivir. If somebody requires mechanical ventilation, we'll start them on steroids.
Receiving blood thinners and convalescent blood plasma are also common treatments. The White House memorandum says the president has also been taking zinc, vitamin D, famotidine, which is a gastrointestinal medication, melatonin, and a daily aspirin.
People in his age range definitely have worse outcomes. That doesn't mean that everybody does, of course, but age is definitely a risk factor. I think we just have to wait and see what the reports are, because again, everybody's disease course is different.
Now, early phase one data from Regeneron trials is promising. Just a few days ago, they said they are seeing very good outcomes in an initial 275 patients receiving the drug intravenously. Cook County Health is also conducting a Regeneron trial, but for people who have not tested positive or shown symptoms as a potential preventive treatment. Now, coming up at 10, we'll have this doctor's reaction to rapid tests and concern over the virus spreading, even when people are testing negative in those rapid tests, as we saw happen this week.
Okay, thank you, Dana. More to follow there. Moving now from treatment to the